in the previous lecture we have already studied the about the what is machine design, and after that the what is standardization, and after that what is preferred numbers that is used in the design. Now in this lecture we will study about the important engineering materials like steel and cast iron and its designation. So okay, so first we know that the steel and cast irons are the material of greater importance in the mechanical engineering field. So our study will be focused on the steel and cast iron, and we all know that steel behaves like a ductile material and cast iron behaves like a brittle material, and I think you all know how the ductile material and brittle material is differentiated. I think everyone knows the material which has appreciable deformation or elongation, that material is ductile material, and the material which has negligible deformation or elongation, then it is called brittle material. And approximately 5% elongation is taken as the boundary to define the ductile material and brittle material. Means if the elongation or contraction is greater than 5%, then the material is treated as ductile material, and if the elongation or contraction is below 5%, then the material may be treated as the brittle material. And a material which behaves like a ductile, suppose it behaves like a ductile at a room temperature, that is 25 degree centigrade, the same material may be brittle if the temperature changes. Means suppose the mild steel is the ductile material, and mild steel is ductile material at room temperature, means 25 degree centigrade, and the same material if you keep the same material in cryogenic environment means below 0 degree centigrade temperature, then the same material may be behaves like a brittle. So ductile and brittle material is defined on the basis of elongation and contraction. Also it depends upon the temperature. Clear? Clear? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now come to the this slide. Already I have explained you what is the machine design, and from this slide I have concluded that we have to study these five topics in our syllabus. This is the unit 1, this is the unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, unit 4 and unit 5. Preferred number we have already studied. Today class we have to study the designation of steel and cast iron. This also comes in under the unit 1. So come to the designation of steel. We know that the steel may be plain carbon steel or alloy steel. Everyone know that द स्टील में भी प्लेन कार्बन स्टील और एलॉय स्टील. प्लेन कार्बन स्टील मीन्स द प्लेन कार्बन स्टील हैज Mn एज ए कंपोनेंट. कार्बन ऑलरेडी इट इज द प्लेन कार्बन स्टील हैज कार्बन आयरन एंड Mn. एंड Ly steel हैज अदर alloying एलिमेंट लाइक निकेल, क्रोमियम, वेनेडियम, वाट एवर वी वॉन्ट टू इम्पार्ट द प्रॉपर्टी इन द स्टील अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट alloying एलिमेंट इज एडेड. सो स्टील कैन बी ऑफ टू टाइप्स, प्लेन कार्बन स्टील एंड Ly steel. द designation of both type of steel means plain carbon steel and alloy steel are different. Okay, I am telling you that the steel may be of two types, plain carbon steel or Ly steel. The designation of plain carbon steel is different and the designation rule of Ly steel is different. So first see the plain carbon steel. It is the BIS system of designation, Bureau of Indian Standard. The plain carbon steel means it has the component carbon, then manganese Mn. So how these plain carbon steel is designated? First you look here, the plain carbon steel may be of three types: low carbon steel, medium carbon steel and high carbon steel. And you know that the steel has the component carbon below 2%, and if the carbon percentage is greater than 2%, then it is called cast iron. So the plain carbon steel may be of three types: low carbon, medium carbon and high carbon steel. Low carbon steel has less than 0.3% carbon. Medium carbon steel has 0.3 to 0.5% carbon, and high carbon steel has greater than 0.5% carbon but less than 2%. Because if the carbon percentage is greater than 2%, in some textbook it is 1.8%, approximately it is 2%. If it is greater than 2%, then the material is called cast iron. For steel, the percentage of carbon is below 2%. Now the plain carbon steel is designated by this figure. This is an example of plain carbon steel. 55 C, capital C. Capital C is for carbon. 4. The plain carbon steel is designated as this figure. This is the example of plain carbon steel. So how this figure comes out? First, you have to calculate the average percentage of carbon. First you have to calculate the average percentage of carbon and multiply this average percentage of carbon by 100. So here it is written a figure indicating 100 times the average percentage of carbon. First you have to calculate the average percentage of carbon and multiply this average percentage by 100. Then this figure comes out 55. After 55 you have to write capital C, and after capital C you have to write percentage of manganese, and this figure is the 10 times the percentage of manganese. Means first you have to calculate the average percentage of manganese and then मल्टीप्लाई दिस एवरेज फिगर बाई 10, द ऑब्टेन्ड फिगर इज 4. क्लियर ना एवरीवन? एवरीवन क्लियर? एवरीवन?
यस सर.
सो सो प्लेन कार्बन इज रिटन 55C4. 55 इज द 100 टाइम्स ऑफ परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन. सी इज फॉर कार्बन एंड 4 इज 10 टाइम्स ऑफ परसेंटेज ऑफ मैग्नीज. क्लियर? नाउ वी कैन सी एन एग्जाम्पल. सपोज सी दिस एग्जाम्पल. डेजिनेट द स्टील विद द फॉलोइंग केमिकल कंपोजिशन एंड द केमिकल कंपोजिशन इज गिवेन कार्बन 0.35 to 0.45%, मैग्नीज 0.7 to 0.9%. सो फर्स्ट स्टेप इज टू कैलकुलेट द एवरेज परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन. द एवरेज परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन विल बी 0.40%. एवरेज ऑफ 0.35 and 0.45, इट कम्स आउट 0.40. एंड एवरेज ऑफ मैग्नीज कम्स आउट 0.8%. एवरेज ऑफ 0.7 and 0.9. सो मल्टीप्लाई 0.40 by 100, बिकॉज इट इज अ परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन. द कार्बन परसेंटेज शुड बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 100. सो मल्टीप्लाई दिस फिगर 0.40 by 100, इट कम्स आउट 40. सो राइट हियर 40. आफ्टर दैट राइट द सी, कैपिटल सी फॉर कार्बन. एंड आफ्टर दैट राइट द 10 टाइम्स ऑफ परसेंटेज ऑफ मैग्नीज. इट इज 0.8, देन मल्टीप्लाई दिस बाई 10, इट कम्स आउट 8. सो द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ दिस कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ स्टील विल बी 40C8. क्लियर? नाउ यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट इफ इन एनी डेजिग्नेशन सी इज प्रजेंट, दिस सी, इट मीन्स इट इज प्लेन कार्बन स्टील. ओनली इन द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ प्लेन कार्बन स्टील द लेटर सी कम्स आउट. एंड इफ सी कम्स आउट, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट बिफोर द सी द फिगर इंडिकेट्स परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन. मीन्स व्हाट विल द परसेंटेज ऑफ कार्बन? 40 upon 100. 40 upon 100 मीन्स 0.40%. एंड आफ्टर सी, द फिगर आफ्टर सी 8 रिप्रेजेंट्स द परसेंटेज ऑफ मैग्नीज. हाउ मच परसेंटेज? 8 by 10, बिकॉज इट इज बिकॉज दिस फिगर कम्स आउट बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग 10. सो द एक्चुअल परसेंटेज ऑफ मैग्नीज विल बी 8 upon 10. इट इज 0.8. सो द परसेंटेज ऑफ मैग्नीज इन दिस स्टील इज 0.8%. सो रिमेंबर दिस डेजिग्नेशन. इफ इन एनी डेजिग्नेशन कैपिटल सी इज प्रेजेंट, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस इज द डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ प्लेन कार्बन स्टील. Because only in the plain carbon steel the capital C comes out. The figure before the capital C represent percentage of carbon if we divide it by 100, and the figure after the letter C represents percentage of manganese if we divide this figure by 10. Everyone clear? Reply me. Reply me. Clear everyone?
Yes sir.
Now I think you all, now you are able to designate the plain carbon steel. There is very simple rule to designate the plain carbon steel, because we know that in plain carbon steel only manganese is present as a constituent other than carbon. So in plain carbon steel only manganese is present other than carbon, then this figure 8 represents the percentage of manganese and 40 represents the percentage of carbon. Now comes to the another steel that is known as free cutting steel. Free cutting steel, and it is also unalloyed, means here also alloying is not done, but some element is added to make the steel free cutting. It is like the plain carbon steel, but another element is also added to make the steel free cutting. And the free cutting element is SSETEPB. These four element is known as free cutting steel, and this is added to the plain carbon steel to make it free cutting steel. So like the plain carbon steel, it is also designated as 25C12S14. 25C12, it is like the plain carbon steel. Like the plain carbon steel, 25C12 is present. In addition this in addition this S and 14 is present here. So like the plain carbon steel, this 25 represents a figure indicating 100 times the average percentage of carbon. C is for carbon. 12 represents a figure indicating 10 times the average percentage of manganese, like the plain carbon steel. After that, S is present. S is nothing, it is a free cutting element, the symbol of element which makes steel free cutting. And these elements are only S, SC, TE and PB. After that, 14 is written here. 14 represents 100 times the average percentage of the element that is present and responsible for free cutting. That means this 14 represents the percentage of sulfur, S. It is like the plain carbon steel, only the free cutting element and its percentage is included in the designation. It means in this steel, the percentage of carbon is 0.25%, the percentage of manganese is 1.2%, because it is a 10 times, so divide 12 by 10, it comes out 1.2. So percentage of manganese is 1.2%. S is present, then you can understand that this is the free cutting steel, because S is the free cutting element. So sulfur as the free cutting element is present here. So this designation represents the designation of free cutting steel. And the what will be the percentage of sulfur? S 14 upon 100, because it is the 100 times the average percentage of the element. So 14 upon 100, it comes out 0.14. So we can write this is the free cutting steel having 0.25% carbon, 1.2% manganese and 0.14% sulfur as free cutting element. Clear? Tell me. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now come to the, you have to remember, listen me, you have to remember which element, which percentage is multiplied by 100 and which percentage is multiplied by 10. You have to remember. If you don't remember this, the the explanation may be go wrong. So you have to remember that which percentage is multiplied by 100. Like here 25 is written by multiplying 100, 14 is written by multiplying 100, but 12 is written by multiplying 10. So you have to remember which quantity is multiplied by 100 and which figure is multiplied by 10. Then only you are able to correctly identify the steel and its percentage of constituents. Clear? Similarly, now come for the designation of alloy steel. We have studied plain carbon steel, free cutting steel. Now come alloy steel. I think now the entry of students can be stopped because it creates so many hindrances in the lecture. Today